Dear 77, 11:39 a.m. For this week's shopman task, the Big Brother house has been transformed into a house of horrors. Big Brother's provided housemates with costumes and makeup for the task. Some of the housemates are in the garden.
Can you imagine if they let us have a ride here for a day? Oh, just blast it out here.
That would be brilliant.
Somebody been listening to all the new tunes. There wouldn't be no information on Big Brother, would there?
They could do a Big Brother's radio.
Yeah, their own radio station. BB Radio 4. Hi, this is Big Brother Channel 4 Radio tuning in. What a beautiful day. It's going to be hot all day. 22. Going up to 27.
This is Big Brother. Would Marcus come to the dining room?
Ooh, Marcus.
Siavash, Rodrigo and Sophie are in the kitchen.
Could you be in more noisy chewing?
No.
Could you?
What do you think?
Be any more noisier?
Chewing. Where?
Chewing. You like?
And she's...
No.
She's been noisy.
I'm imitating what he was doing.
She's been eating like a fucking pig.
Yeah.
Only because you look like one, Sophie, doesn't mean you have to eat like one.
Shut up. I'll
eat like a pig and look like a cow.
That's just rude. Absolutely rude. No, I'm not snooting, I'm afraid. You can laugh all you like.
Hello, Marcus. How are you?
Not bad, thank you for asking. How are you?
Marcus, between when you first came into the house and now, how do you think your housemates would have described you?
Something to my own fault that I didn't, or that I neglected to mention with everyone else, is how far I take jokes. And I think a lot of people thought all the things that I was saying before were serious. And now that they've just been around it for a while, they can actually see how brilliantly well observed and funny all my jokes are, and how I practically am the He-Man of comedy. And as you can see with how they talk and everything like that, they're using my jokes and catchphrases and swearing and everything like that. And opinions have changed.
Do you feel that your relationships with people in the house have changed?
I think sort of Sophie's turned a corner. I think she's sort of like friendly with me just for the sake of it, for a good few weeks, and I think now it's more of a proper friendship, or a Big Brother friendship. And Lisa a lot as well, but I think Lisa made some good observations and stuff before anyone else, but she's getting on the swear word catchphrase bandwagon a lot more. I think a few people in here look up to Alicia as well, so she's doing it and other people do it as well. It's like they look to her for permission to do it, so now she's doing it, a lot of other people are.
Who do you think is getting on the bandwagon?
Siavash. He's always going around and making sure that he's sweet with everyone, and that if anything does happen, he'd be the last person to get the finger pointed. He'll run to the top of the mountain before he starts a flood. People at the bottom of the mountain are going to drown, but why does he give a toss when he's at the top of the mountain, like, you know, and the water's not going to reach him? He does it every single time. No one else in this house talks like he does about nominations and being in the final and stuff like that, or at the same time talks about not giving a shit and you don't care about the game and blah, blah, blah. For somebody who doesn't care about the game, you know, he seems to be doing pretty well, and it's definitely not just by him being here being himself. What reason is there to stay towards the final or win or whatever? It's a lot just to do with either greed or ego, and as far as this game show is concerned, I don't have either of them. I don't have to make anyone proud. I'm not doing this for anyone else. My friends, you know, I don't think they give a toss if I win or if I go home today or tomorrow or stay forever. You know, apart from selfish reasons, I don't really have a reason to stay.
...12:51 p.m. David, Lisa and Charlie are in the kitchen.
Where's the mayonnaise?
Oh, I don't tell there's none left. Should be,
there was a big load of it. Yeah.
Who keeps them not putting it back in? You can't keep it refrigerated and they're not refrigerating it. Third of you, when you get it in the shop, it's not refrigerated, but it's just once open, keep refrigerated. Yeah. You keep people keep putting it goes off. In fact, I don't even want to use it. It actually smells off. It's fucking disgusting.
B, Sophie, and Rodrigo are in the sitting room. Last night, B admitted to David that she nominated him.
David's not very happy with me at all.
Is he still not happy?
No, but...
Oh, well.
You know, he's like, doesn't like my reasons, but... Who is going to like, you know, if anybody gets nominated, you've got to give a reason for everyone, and no one would like the reason they get nominated.
You just pick stupid reasons now because we've got no reason to nominate each other.
You pick excuses, yeah. Not reasons.
The little thing.
You know, you can't go in and say, I'd like to nominate David because I think he's absolutely lovely. You know, you can't do that. So
he's the nicest guy I think I've ever met. That's why I want to nominate him.
This is Big Brother. Would Charlie come to the diary room?
Don't care. I've told them over. But then they will think, because if you go to the fridge, you'll see that and you'll think, oh, God, shit, I've got to fucking remember. I don't care, it's doing my head in. No.
Can you get that out for us, love?
Sick to death.
Was these on the left?
Charlie, as you know, tampering with any fixtures or fittings in the Big Brother house is against the rules.
I know you're not allowed to write on bits of paper, because that's against rules. I thought I didn't know that was tampering with it. I'm just writing something on. Well, will you make us a little laminated sign that I can stick on for them all to read? So it's really, really getting to us. They've been here like 11 weeks, some of them, and they still cannot do it. They still can't grasp the fact. If you get something from somewhere, put it back to where you got it from. What is the problem with that? Absolutely upset. It's really upsetting us. It's getting nervous. I don't know why people can't just do it.
Charlie, do you not think there's another way that you can get this message across to your fellow housemates?
Big Brother, we've tried everything. I've sat them down at the table, right, meeting at the table, right, people are doing this, people are doing that. You sit them down and they're like, oh, yeah, it's fine. One day it works, next day it's back to normal, they forget. People are like, glasses all over, mess all over. Why can people not just clean up after themselves? It's really, really bad when you're in a house full of, like, people. You've got to have consideration for others, and they just haven't.
Charlie, when you leave the diary room, you must wipe the message off the fridge immediately and ensure that it's clean as it was before. Do you understand?
Well, no. Why can't I just... Can everyone say it? I'm going to wipe it off once everyone's seen it. I want them to see it. I did it for a reason. I didn't do it to be stubborn or anything. I did it because I want people to understand. Because I'll say it to them, and they'll not say it. I want them to see it and think, God, then I'll wipe it off. It'll come straight off, no bother.
Charlie, Big Brother will clarify one more time.
I'll just go and wipe it off. I'm not bothered. I'll do it now. Will you let us out, please? I'm going to wipe it off. Please. I'm sick to death. Thank you. Fucking idiots.
What?
Fucking wipe the message off the fridge just as I will. When fucking people have seen it, the stupid can't be bothered. Cannot be bothered. Wipe the fucking thing off the fridge. I said I was going to once people have seen it, but it's fine. Watch.
Told ya.
Absolutely fine. I'm not bothered.
I said don't do it on there.
I'm not bothered, but where else can I do it?
Can you tell him?
Have I not done that before? I'm not putting anything back where I found it. I'm not doing a single thing in this house. No, that's it. It's made me sick in this. It's really, really sick in this.